Shalom, Ma Shalomcha, Ma Shalomeh, bless up. So videos like what I'm about to interpret, it proves why people like me are essential, because a lot of people will pick up this nonsense that this guy is talking in this video that really don't comprehend law, and they would take it as the truth. So let's disseminate this nonsense that he's teaching people. And be extremely careful following these people that you see on social media. If you want the truth, come to Kahan Tazadot channel on YouTube. And also, he also done a video on the Gullah Wars, which I did about probably 13 years ago. YouTube eventually flagged me for it because of the truths in it, but I still have it on. I re-uploaded it to Rumble about a year ago. But a lot of these people, they just going around snatching information and then claiming it as their own. Let's tune into his video.
Yo, what's going on, people? So I want to tell you about the most important lawsuit pending in this country right now. It is a lawsuit that has been filed against the state of Georgia in the Fulton County Superior Court, who had to be drop-served summons in this case and has refused to appear after 30 days of being served. Because they won't.
I can assure you that the state of Georgia has not refused to appear. It's just that they deemed this guy's interpretation of the law incompetent, and rightfully so. After I disseminate this video, you understand why.
Because they want no parts to do with what this case proves. And that is that millions of non-absent parents and fathers have been paying child support unconstitutionally.
Now, take note of what this guy he said. What he said. He said millions of non-absent parents. So if you understand law, and if you define the term absent parent, which I'll get to, he's saying non-absent parent, right? So that means that would be the primary custodian. This guy's a complete idiot, and he has aphasia. He definitely doesn't understand the language of law, and no one should be listening to this guy.
According to the 11th Circuit, the remedy has always been staring the people in the face. It is clear that families with absent fathers are the intended beneficiaries of Title 4D. So what if I told you that a young black brother from the state of Georgia has now legally articulated who is non-absent? Follow me for part two.
And mind you, he keeps using the term non-absent. That means the parent is present. And so if one parent is considered to be an absent parent, according to the legal definition, then that's a parent that's not the primary custodian that may not be physically living with the child. So a non-absent parent, to this man's ignorance, is the parent that's physically living with the child. This guy suffers from aphasia severely. And he probably had a lobotomy. And I bet he believes what he's really thinking and stating, or as he said, articulating, is true. It's actually asinine and incompetent.
That millions of. So in part one of this series, I left off describing how I prove in this Fulton County case that millions of non-absent parents are paying child support unconstitutionally, and how I legally articulated who is a non-absent parent. Now, according to the Supreme Court cases on the screen, which has never been overturned, and basic common sense, a parent cannot be an absent parent if that parent's absence is caused through no fault of his or her own.
Now, to disagree. After listening to this guy and several other people that claim to have a remedy for the whole child support thing, it becomes apparent why. You know, social media has to screen some people because this right here is dangerous. It got a lot of people false hopes, false dreams, but it's not really a remedy. Now, his interpretation of what an absent parent is far-fetched. And it's really out of touch of reality. So an absent parent could simply be and simply is, according to the legal definition of the word, is a parent that's not physically living with the child. That's an absent parent. It doesn't necessarily mean a parent that's totally abandoned the parental rights, because an absent parent still has parental rights in some situations. It's just a parent that's not physically living with the child, and since still not the primary custodian, the system had them to pay child support. Do you understand?
Now, to disagree would be similar to an officer holding the passenger of a vehicle liable to the laws of speeding and not the actual driver. Using this same analogy, how can a parent, absent through no fault of his or her own, be liable under Title 4D laws specifically created to decrease dependency on welfare arising from absent parents in the household?
Now, this is. I realize what I'm stating is disappointing to a lot of men, right? But you need to know the truth and not these lies that this guy's actually fabricating, right? So a parent could become absent, simply the woman could leave. And she leaves with the children are still physically with her. So even though the guy didn't leave, he's still considered to be the absent parent. It's simple law. Common sense, which he claimed to have, but obviously do not.
Household. Now, this is not based on my belief, but based on Supreme Court cases. With one Indiana Supreme Court case that will ring bells across this country in this stating, and I quote, when a man abandons his child and casts it upon the public, he becomes liable for its support. But it is entirely impossible to treat a child as thus cast upon the public, when the fact simply is the mother has deserted the father and carried the child away. Now, this describes the occurrence of what millions of fathers were going through before the creation of their support orders. The fact which by operation rewarded the mother in monthly payments for 18 years for parental alienation, when according to natural law, this should have never occurred or ever happened. Again, not based on my belief, but Supreme Court cases, with one Georgia Supreme Court case stating that whatever deprives the parent of the right to the custody of the child without fault on his part relieves him from the duty to support. Even the Supreme Court New Hampshire case in 1984 stated that the obligation of the parent to support the child is contingent upon the parent actually retaining custody. So what this means is, this case proves that a parent is only obligated to pay support to their child while in their own household until he or she burdens the other parent with financial support in his or her absence. And anything less is state interference on privacy rights absent a legitimate state interest. Follow for part three.
Again, this guy is what you refer to as a jailhouse attorney. Not necessarily somebody that's been to jail, but in most cases is someone that actually went to jail, prison, and they decided to pick up a law book. Not everyone that actually picks up law books have a comprehensive knowledge of law as this guy. Now, he's saying that if the parent did not abandon the child, then he's not obliged to pay child support. In a nutshell, is basically what he's saying. Of course, I'm paraphrasing that, right? Now, he's saying if he didn't abandon him, then he's not obliged, but he is. Because there's several types of custody, right? Now, you can have what is known as a physical custody, the primary custodian. And if the woman is the primary custodian, the way that this system is set up, the non-primary custodian is going to be paying support. And they're considered to be an absent parent because they're not physically living with the child. I mean, it's really simple. And it seems as though if you don't understand law, that this guy's aware of what he's talking about. This guy has no darn clue what he's talking about. And a lot of people's going to be led to disappointment listening to this garbage. If you think what he really was stating was a remedy, do you think so many fathers would be suffering from this child support thing? I'm not trying to disappoint guys. I'm just trying to teach you the truth. If you really want truth, you really want real remedy, come to Kahan Tells a Doc on YouTube or visit www.kahantellsadoc.net. Let's continue. But in those videos, I'll interpret what an absent parent actually is, and you'll see that this guy suffers from aphasia. So be certain to tune into part two of my video, Get the Truth.